Good morning, students. In last class, we have studied about the functions of commercial bank. Today, we are going to see about the warehousing. Okay. So, warehouse is a place where goods are stored for future purposes. That is, we are getting the goods whenever we need it in order to store the goods in the warehouse. Okay. So, all the goods are stored in warehouse in order to get the goods at a right time and right place. Okay, so here the goods are produced in industries in bulk manner, that is in mass quantity. Those goods are stored in a warehouse because it is used all over the world. So it is stored in the near place of warehouse where the retail shop is situated. Okay, so warehouse plays an important role in order to get the goods at right time, at right place. Not only to get the goods at right time and right place, but also it provide the goods in good manner, in good quality conditions. So in this chapter, we are going to see the warehousing, meaning of warehousing, warehouses. There is a difference between warehouses and warehousing, and the different types of warehouses, as well as the functions of warehouse, and kinds of warehousing, as well as the document needed to warehouse the product. Okay, so the first topic is about introduction. So here they said that the term ware means product or goods. Okay, so housing means you are storing. Okay, so products or goods are stored in a place, that place is called as warehouse. Okay, storage is only a holding place of goods. Okay, so warehouse is located near the market in order to perform the other marketing functions such as grading, standardization, blending, mining, packing. All those activities are carried out in the warehouse. Okay, then meaning of warehouse, the place, already I said, the place where goods are stored is called as warehouse for future use and act as a distribution center. So the warehouse is acting as a distribution center. From the warehouse, the goods are distributed to various retail shop or wholesale shop, whatever it may be, according to their market condition. Then, for example, to keep perishable goods, fruits and vegetables, these are stored in a cold storage warehouse. Certain pharmaceutical goods are kept in suitable temperature. And liquids like petrol, oil molasses need tanks, while grains like barley, pulses, all those things needed ventilated halls. Okay, so depending upon the goods, the storage places also vary. Okay, so according to J. Stephenson, warehouse is an establishment for the storage or accumulation of goods. That is, it is a establishment in order to store goods in a place. Storing, accumulation are both of the one and the same words used here. Okay, then warehousing. So warehousing is an arrangement by which goods are stored. That is, it is only an arrangement, it is not a place. Okay, so there is a difference between a warehouse as well as a warehousing. So a warehouse is a commercial building for storage of goods. Okay, so stored goods can include raw material or packing material or spare parts, component or finished goods, whatever it may be. If it is stored for future consumption, then it is called a warehouse. Okay, difference between warehouse and warehousing. Okay, already I said that warehouse is a place where goods are stored for future use, whereas warehousing is an arrangement of goods. Okay, so this is the main difference. Warehousing is a arranging. You are arranging the goods according to the types of goods, according to the condition needed for the goods. That is called warehousing. Whereas warehouse is a place. Okay, so there is a difference between warehouse and a warehousing. Then next topic is about need for warehousing. The first need for warehousing is the goods are produced in mass production. That is, mass production is the first one. So production is taken place in mass quantity. Those goods are stored in a modern warehousing facilities. Okay, so the market for such goods is spread all over the world. Therefore, warehouse is needed in different places in order to store the goods. Okay, then nature of commodities. So some commodities need warehouse facilities. For example, perishable in nature means that is, for example, fruits, flowers, all those things are comes under vegetables. All those comes under in perishable in nature. Not only this, fish also. Okay, so these goods are stored in cold storage places. So storing them in cold storages can extend the life of the goods. Okay, so not only that, it also avoid deterioration of goods. Okay, damages of goods, wastage of goods. All those things comes under this. Then seasonal production, but regular consumption. Some goods are consumed regularly, for example wheat, sugar and pulses, but these goods are produced in season, some season only. Okay, so during those season they are produced and stored in a warehouse and it is used throughout the year. Okay, so this is the concept regarding the seasonal production but regular consumption. The next one is regular production but seasonal consumption. So certain goods are produced regularly. The opposite to this is regular production, but it is used in season. For example, raincoat, all those things comes under these categories. It is produced throughout the year, whereas its consumption is used only in rainy season. Okay, so certain goods are produced regularly throughout the year, but they are demanded in season only. The examples are raincoats, blankets, umbrella, all those things comes under these categories. Okay, the next topic is relating to proximity to production centers. That is, some centers sometimes because of delay some products are not get by the consumer at right time. So during the, so in order to provide those goods, regular fed to the warehouse is situated at different market areas. Okay, production of goods at specific center need to be supplied in time, that is without delay, without interruption. So in order to provide those goods, warehouse is needed. Then now we are going to see the types of warehouse. So the types of warehouse, can be classified as follows: on the base of ownership, on the base of commodity stored. It is two types. On the base of ownership, there are six categories are there. One is private warehouse, government warehouse, public warehouse, cooperative warehouse, bonded warehouse, institutional warehouse, and distribution center warehouse. On the base of ownership, it is divided into general warehouse, special commodity warehouse, cold storage warehouse, climate control warehouse. Okay, so first we are going to see about the, on the base of ownership, private warehouses. So these warehouses are built and owned by the private persons. Okay, in order to store the product produced by him only, that is for his own purposes he is running that warehouses. Okay, so they are exclusively for their own use and not meant for manufacturing or business units. The next one is about government warehouses. So these warehouses are created and operated by the government to implement the programs of the government. That is, these warehouses are run by the government in order to carry out the services most available to government only. So here next we are going to see about public warehouse. So public warehouse is open for public at large. Okay, so this, in these warehouses operate as per the rules and regulation formed by the government. So they may be most of the business organization, especially the small and medium scale units, offered this type of warehouses. Okay, then cooperative warehouses. So these are owned by cooperative societies or agriculture or cooperative societies. They are set up to provide warehousing facilities to their members. Example, National Cooperative Development Corporation, NCDC, are comes under this category. Next one is about bonded warehouse. So these warehouses are licensed by the government to accept the storage of imported goods. Okay, so this is for imported goods. For bonded warehouse is meant for imported goods which are not clear due to non-payment of custom duty are stored in these bonded warehouses. Bank loans can be obtained by submitting the receipt issued by these warehouses as collateral security. The next one we are going to see about the institutional warehouses. So next one is about institutional warehouses. Different institutions and bodies open these warehouses. For example, banks, railways have their own warehouse for conducting their activities. So this is about institutional warehousing. Okay, so next one is about distribution center warehouse. Okay, so distribution center warehousing is nothing but distribution center warehousing. 1 minute students. So first we studied about on the basis of collateral security, it is divided into two categories. The next one is about in warehousing. So we studied about the difference between warehouse as well as warehousing. Okay, so the next topic is related to institutional warehouses. So institutional warehouses is different institution and bodies have their own warehouses on account of the nature of their operation. For example, banks, railways, etc. have their own warehousing for conducting their activities. Then distribution center warehouses. Here these warehouses are temporarily stored for 1 or 2 days only, because these warehouses are used for distribution of goods at different centers. Okay, so they are owned by the manufacturer or wholesaler. So on the base of commodities, so they are ordinarily warehouses which are useful for storing most of the dry food, grains, fertilizer, protective measures against rat and insects are comes under this category. Then special commodity warehouse. So special commodities warehouse, these warehouses reduce loss of quality and quantity to a great extent. So they are constructed for storing specific type of goods. For example, tobacco, cotton, wool, all those things comes under this category. Then next one is about cold storage refrigerated warehouses. These warehouses are used for storing perishable goods like fruits, vegetable, eggs, butter, fish, meat, etc. Then climate control warehouses. So humidity control environment for delicate products such as flowers in dirt free facilities in these warehouses. Then next one is about automated warehouses. So these warehouses handle several hundreds of kilograms of products at a time. So these warehouses premises physically distribution activities are carried out. It requires huge investment and latest technology and a large turnover of goods. The next one is about functions of warehouse. There are different functions are performed by the warehouse other than storage. So warehouse render invaluable services to the society by performing the following function. The first one is about storage. The main function is storage of goods in order to distribute them at right time according to their demand and supplies. So then price stabilization. Because of a storage of goods, the stability in the price, that is increase and decrease in price level, is stabilized by the warehousing. Warehousing ensures price stabilization by supplying goods as and when required. Okay, then equalization of demand and supplies. Warehousing equalize the demand and supply of goods by storing the goods when they are demanded and release them when there is a demand. Okay, so this thus the consumer get the commodities regularly even during the off season also. Okay, so next one is about business finance. The next functions of warehousing is business finance. Here we are getting financial assistance from the financial institution by way of giving the receipt of the warehouse, that is the warehouse receipt. Okay, then next one is a risk bearing. Damage of the goods and warehouse keeper compensate the loss caused to the owner of the goods. Thus warehouse bear the loss involved in
storage of goods. Then preparation for sale. So modern warehouses undertake the storage function as well as packing, labeling, all those things, standarding, all those things carried out in warehousing. Hence, warehousing is needed for making the goods suitable for sales. Then next one is widening the market area. So because of warehouse, the goods are distributed in different centers. So it widened the market area of the places. Then value added services. So warehouse also provides certain value added services such as transits, mixing, grading, packaging and labeling. Some goods are repacked and labeled again at the time of inspection by prospective buyers. The next we are going to see about advantages as well as drawbacks of warehousing. So the main advantages is it safeguards the stock of the merchants. Warehouse reduces distribution cost of traders. It helps in selection of channel of distributions. The producer will prefer whether to appoint a wholesaler or retailer. It assists in maintaining the continuous sales. It creates employment opportunity for both skilled and unskilled workers. It improves the standard of the living of the people. So next we are going to see about the drawbacks of warehousing. Warehousing is not effective because of the following reason. The first one is about there is no adequate transport facilities between the place of production and warehouse. This is in some villages they are drawbacks regarding the transport facilities. The next one is about lack of sufficient storage facilities is one of the drawbacks. The next one is complicated formalities. Formalities are very complicated in order to store the goods in the warehouse. So the illiterate and innocent farmers are not able to cope up with these formalities. Then complicated process of barcode technology and unavoidable delay for obtaining financial assistance may cause loss of the owner of the goods. So these are the drawbacks of warehousing. The next one is about warehousing documents. So the following are the documents used in connection with the warehousing. One is warehouse warrant, warehouse keeper receipt, dock warrant, dock receipt and delivery order. So these are the warehousing document needed in order to store the goods in the warehouse. Then warehousing in India. India is an agrarian country, but the importance of warehousing was not felt till 1950. Okay. So on the recommendation of the All India Rural Credit Survey Committee, the Agricultural Produce Corporation Act enacted in 1956 authorized the government to set up National Cooperative Development and Warehousing Board to develop agricultural cooperative and warehousing. So the main warehousing agencies in the public sectors are comes under. So here there is a difference between the warehouse warrant and warehouse receipt. Okay. So next one is about main warehousing agencies in public sector. Food Corporation of India, that is FCIA. It provides storage facility for food grains. Food Corporation of India also hires storage capacity from other sources such as Central Warehousing Corporation, State Warehousing Corporation and Private Warehousing Corporation. The next one is about Central Warehousing Corporation. It was established in 1957. And the available storage capacity is here 11.17 million tons and with the operation throughout 464 warehousing center across the country. Then about functions of the Central Warehousing Corporation. To provide agency services for scientific storage of agriculture product, seeds, manures, fertilizer, agriculture implements and other notified commodities, as well as to issue negotiable warehouse receipt. So issue receipt for the procuring credit to the owner of the goods, to preserve the product deposited with care and product against insects and various pests, and to act as an agent for the government and to reduce the cost of storage facilities. Then State Warehousing Corporation, SWC. So every state government is given power to establish its own warehousing corporation after getting the approval from the
Central Warehousing Corporation. 50% of the capital is produced contributed by the CWC, that is Central Warehousing Corporation, and the remaining 50% is contributed by the state cooperative, state government. Then Tamil Nadu Warehousing Corporation, TNWC, it was established in 1959. Nearly 6.83 lakhs empty with 7 regional offices and 256 godowns across the state. It is one of the biggest public warehouse operating in the state, offering logistic services to the diverse group of clients. So these are the topics related to the warehouse. First we studied about what is the meaning of warehouse, as well as warehousing, the different functions of warehousing, advantages of warehousing, disadvantages of warehousing, as well as the warehousing in India and the main warehousing agency in public sector. So these are the concepts we have studied, we have studied in today classes. Okay, study well, do the assignment then and there in order to score more marks, as well as study for your monthly test. Thank you, students.